This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this is going to be the first of a series of videos about permutations and combinations. So let's start with permutations. Let's say I've got four objects, like the four letters A, B, C, and D. And I want to know how many different arrangements I could make with these four objects. I can figure this out with a tree diagram. So I'll start a tree diagram with four branches, one for each of the four letters that I could take for the first letter in my arrangement, A, B, C, and D. Now, if A is the first letter in the arrangement, there are three different letters that I could have as the second letter, B, C, or D. If B is the first letter, then my second letter could be an A, a C, or a D. If C is the first letter, then the second letter could be an A, a B, or a D. And if D is the first letter, my second letter could be A, B, or C. So now I've got four different ways to choose the first letter, and for each of those four ways, there are three ways to choose the second letter. So I've got four times three different ways of taking the first two letters. Now, when I want to go on to the third letter, there are going to be two options left for each of these 12 branches. If I've chosen A and then B, I would have the choice of choosing either C or D for my third letter. And I would have two options left for the other branches as well. So now I would have four times three times two different ways to arrange those three letters from that four-letter set. As far as the fourth letter is concerned, there's only going to be that one fourth letter left, so I'm going to have four times three times two times one, which doesn't change anything. Four times three times two times one, number of ways of arranging these four letters, and that's going to be 24. Now, there's a mathematical symbol we can use that will speed this up. I can say that there are four and an exclamation point after it. Four, this is read as four factorial. Four factorial ways of arranging all four of the objects in a four object set. The factorial sign, this exclamation point, means this. You take the number before the exclamation point, in this case the four, and then you multiply it by each of the whole numbers that are less than that number. So I take the four and multiply it by three, then multiply that by two, then multiply that by one. That's how I got my 24. In general, if we have a set of, let's say, n objects, and I want to know how many different ways there are to arrange them or permute them, I'm going to just say there are n factorial different permutations of n objects. The factorial symbol comes in really handy if you have large numbers. If you had a set of playing cards, 52 different cards, and you wanted to know how many different permutations there would be of those playing cards, you could just say that it's 52 factorial. Most calculators nowadays have a factorial button or a series of buttons you can press to tell you what a large number like 52 factorial would be. Okay, let's go on and explore this a little more. So let's say I've got seven objects. I'll use the letters A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And I only want to take three of them for my permutation. Okay, well, there's going to be seven ways I could choose the first object. I could choose any one of these seven letters. After I've chosen a first letter, there'll be six letters left that I could choose as my second letter. And after I've chosen the second letter, there'll be five letters left that I could choose for the third letter. So there would be seven times six times five different permutations of seven objects if I'm only taking three of them. There's a notation we can use for this. The notation is a subscript n, and then a capital P and a subscript r. This is read usually as npr or npermute r. Let's explain what that means, and I'll tell you what the formula is. So the n is the total number of objects. So in our case, n would be 7. The P is for permute, because we're doing permutations. And the R is going to be how many of those objects we're taking. So in our case, we're just taking 3 objects. Now the formula is n factorial divided by n minus R factorial. So in the case of this problem, n would be 7, the total number of objects. So I'll have n factorial. And then since r is the number of objects I'm taking, I would have n minus r is 7 minus 3. And that's factorial. And I can turn that into 7 factorial over 7 minus 3 is 4. So that's 4 factorial. Okay, let's expand this and see what we can do with it. So 7 factorial is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Now I can take this fraction and simplify it by canceling out both of the 4s, both of the 3s, both of the 2s, and both of the 1s. And what I'm left with is 7 times 6 times 5, which is what I got at first when I just thought through how many different permutations might I have. Okay, so this is the formula we're going to use for permutations. Now, before we leave this, let's check something out. Let's take that formula and make sure it works if we're going to choose all of the objects, if we're going to permute all of the objects in the set. So let's go back to the idea of there being 7 objects in a set. That means for NPR, I'm going to have 7 permute 7. N factorial would be 7 factorial. And N minus R would be 7 minus 7. I want that factorial. Now let's see what we can do with this. So 7 factorial, I'll just leave that as 7 factorial for now. 7 minus 7 is 0. So this is 0 factorial. Now we know from what we looked at previously that if there are 7 different objects, and I'm going to take all of them, they're going to be 7 factorial permutations. But I've got 7 factorial over 0 factorial. So the only way I can make this fraction equal 7 factorial would be if 0 factorial equaled 1. So what mathematicians have done is they've defined 0 factorial as equaling 1. And that means 7 factorial over 0 factorial is 7 factorial over 1. And that just equals 7 factorial. So what you want to remember is, if you're dealing with this kind of problem, that when you get to 0 factorial, that does not equal 0, it equals 1. Okay, so there's a bit more I want to say about permutations, and then I want to go on to combinations. I'm not going to have enough time for that in this video, so I'll put up a couple more videos after this going on to those topics. Okay, take care. I'll see you soon.